That was an introduction. I'm really honored to be here with you guys this evening. And when Helen told me that she invited me to be one of the speakers, you know, I asked what is the theme of the event and what's it all about? Because for me, I'm all about priorities and having focus on what you want to do. So every event has to have something, you know, something I call the EUS, which is essential, you know, underlying spirit. So what's the essential underlying spirit of an event before I put myself there? So as she told me, it's press for progress. And I had to, you know, go in to search more about what do I see as progress. And as a woman, what do I look for when I say I want to press for progress? You know, there's something happening, but I call it a trend. You know, it's quite very easy for all of us to jump on the bandwagon of one campaign to another without even asking questions, without understanding what is this campaign all about, how does it, you know, give us that progress. Took your face on my face. You know. So please photographer, if you can allow me to speak, that would be nice. Thank you. So, you know, I think about so many things that are happening. People, you know, are very quick to jump on things without thinking it through, without understanding what it's all about. You know, so I had to sit down to think, what is press for progress for me personally as a woman, and then for my children and my fellow women? First of all, my name is Faustina. I'm a writer and I'm a publisher. I'm also, you know, I call myself a women advocate because of my own experience. Now, I grew up at the age of 4, you know, I witnessed a lot of domestic violence in my own family. My mom, who came from a wealthy family, who is educated, you know, got into a relationship which destroyed her focus, which destroyed her life purpose. And that experience, all of my life, has really shaped me on how I take, you know, how I prioritize myself and how I, you know, think. And that brings me straight to what, you know, the things I want to talk about today. So when I look at press for progress, I see it from the point of, you know, finding out your priorities as a woman. And these priorities, I brought them down to 3 major things. And these major things are relationships, your mental health, and then finding your success, finding yourself, discovering yourself. You know, I put relationship first because relationship is one of the first things that, you know, once a woman grows up, you are definitely going to get into a relationship. And that is the first thing that is going to really introduce you into the world of associating with people outside your home, especially when it has to do with the opposite sex. Now, before one goes into a relationship, there are several things you need to think about. What is your aim in life? What do you want to achieve for yourself? That alone should be what should guide you in deciding who am I going to get involved with. Because if you get it wrong, your life, you know, your dreams, all the things, your ambition could be cut short as a woman. So it's very important for us as women to think very hard about who we want to get involved with. You know, relationship for a woman is very, it's beyond the physical, it's beyond what you just see, it's beyond just meeting somebody and discussing or staying or moving out with somebody. It goes deeper into us. We women, we are emotional more than any other thing. So we get involved with our emotions, with our hearts. You know, so and you must love yourself more than anything and be able to understand who you are, what you want for yourself. You know, what do you want to achieve? What do you want to give to life? And what do you want from life? These are the things that should guide you in deciding who you get involved with. I remember when I got married, before I got married, you know, I've had a few relationships. And each time, if I meet a guy, I'll be watching. Once I see a threat, any little threat of my dad, I'm out. You know, you know, if I see any little thing that resembles how my dad would behave, I'm out. So that is why it's very, very important that we prepare our children, our girls, in the environment our children grow up. Is very, very vital in their life development and, you know, as they progress in their lives. So the experiences we have, the things we have seen in our lives, they come together to shape us and shape the way we think. So which makes it very, very important that we create a very healthy environment for our children. So, and when you as a woman, when you're going into a relationship, you're not just doing it for yourself, you're also doing it for your own kids. You know, so, like I was saying, you know, the few relationships that I had, so at a point, my mom was really very, you know, very worried about me. She was thinking, is she going to get married? You know, growing up in Nigeria, once you're of age, you're not married, people start getting worried, so it's really a big problem. So, my mom used to be worried and said, sometimes she would call me and she would ask me anybody, anything. I told her, you don't have to ask me this, I know when I want to, you know. But then when I met my husband, who I'm married to now, I met him for the first day. I never knew him before. I met him for the first day. We chatted. I met him again the second time. We had chats and all that. On the third day, we decided to get married. I met him only 3 times. And when I came back, I told my mom, I'm getting married. She was like, what? Is that how they get married? You met this guy only 3 times, you. I know you're going to run away. I said to my mom, no, you know, because I've seen the qualities that I want in a guy. It's not about money, it's not about, you know, it's not, I don't know, it's not even about the looks. Even though my husband is a guy. You know, so my husband had the 3 major qualities I wanted from a guy. He was humble, and he was observant, and he was appreciative. Those are the 3 things that I wanted in a guy. Then the other things followed. He's educated, he had, you know, other things. But those were my major things. Somebody who appreciates you, any little thing that you do. Somebody who is humble, who is not putting himself in your face, who is not doing anything to bring you down in any way. You know, those are the major things that, for me, personally, I look out for when I meet a guy. And that brings me to the next thing. Your mental health. You see, like I said, relationship. You cannot separate a woman's mental health from her relationship. Like I said, your relationship, you know, goes beyond the physical. We women, we have a lot of responsibilities in a relationship, no matter how you want to look at it. Look at in our homes, look at in the society, we have a lot of roles to play. And that is why it's very important for us as women, even when you're bringing up your own sons, We need to hold ourselves down and let them see and respect the role of women anywhere they are. And which is what Press for Progress should be, making men and the society to understand and respect and value the roles of women. So when we talk of equality, we have to really understand these facts. You know, because men and women are built differently for different purposes. No matter how political correctness or whatever we want to apply. The fact is, biologically, physically, mentally, women are built differently from men. And that's where nature made us, gave us several roles to play. And when we are interrupted in our role, it causes us a lot of problems, which is why relationship is important. And that brings us to our mental health. Women go through several, biological issues on its own. Like every month, you know what we go through. You have to go through menstrual cycle, you have to go through ovulation. Those already put pressure on you as a woman. And then if you have extra issues around you, adding more pressures, then you put yourself, your mental health at risk. And once a woman's mental health is destroyed, you destroy the family. The family will be gone, your children are in danger. And once your family, your children are in danger, the society itself is at risk. And that is what we are facing now. You know, when we talk of what is happening in politics, what is happening in society, our children are killing themselves on the street, knife crime, gun crime, whatever you want to call it, the root comes back to the family. And when you look at it, you can see that it comes straight down on the mother. If a woman is not grounded, if a woman doesn't have the real support she needs, everybody suffers. Both the children, both the husband, both the society suffer. So it's very, very important that a woman has the support that she needs. And first of all, as a woman, you need to know that you yourself need that support. You must value yourself first as a woman. You must be selfish when it comes to this. Your mental health comes first, your value comes first. You need to understand, what do I need? What are the support that I need to be the best I can? Because when you don't have the best of yourself, you cannot give anything to anyone. So for us to press for progress, we need to look critically on how we decide to get involved in relationship. We need to think family cohesion. We need to think the mental health of the woman, the support that a woman needs. When and how do you get these things that you need for you to be able to be, you know, effective enough to produce the children or the society that we require? Even outside the family, think of it in your office. Most of the times, once there's a woman in an office, you become the mother in that office automatically, no matter how old, young or old you are. Automatically, you become the nurturer of that environment. So, women lead by nurturing. It's natural with us. Once a woman comes in here, you want to be sure that everybody's okay. You want to be sure, you know, you make things or you organize things. That is us as women. That is how we are built. So, it's important that us as a woman, at every point in time, you have to be sure of your own mental health. And I have this, I would like you all to read this with me. This is something I wrote, it's inside my book, you know, and it's called Mind Your Mind, My Mental Health prayed. So please, I would like you to read after me. I pledge to myself.
I pledge to
myself.
I pledge to myself.
To mind my mind at all times.
To mind my mind at all times.
To not be strong.
To not be strong.
To not be strong.
To not be strong.
But seek help.
But seek help.
Before reaching my breaking point.
Before reaching my breaking point.
To take a break.
To take a break.
And move away.
And move away.
From anything.
From anything.
That threatens my mind.
That threatens my mind.
Body and soul.
Body and soul.
It is perfectly right.
It is perfectly right.
And for my own good.
And for my own good.
To think myself first.
To think myself first.
Knowing if I'm not fixed.
Knowing that if I'm not fixed.
I can't fix anyone else.
I cannot fix anyone else.
To speak up.
To speak up.
And speak out.
And speak out.
Of my feelings.
Of my feelings.
So that people around me.
So that people around me.
Will understand.
Will understand.
What I'm going through.
What I'm going through.
To protect my space.
To protect my space.
From any negative association. Of people, substance, or activity.
Or activity.
I know that I will need my mind.
I will need my mind
as well as my body.
As well as my body.
Intact.
Intact.
For me to achieve any success.
For me to achieve any success.
I will be a woman.
I will be a woman
who minds her mind.
Who minds her mind.
So this is a place that, you know, I developed and I think contains almost everything you need as a woman, because sometimes we forget ourselves trying to give to everyone, you know. Sometimes you need to take a break. You need to take account of what you've been, you know, you've been involved with. Even your, from time to time, as a woman, you need to move away from every activity around you and go inside yourself, meditate, discover yourself, find yourself, you know, and if there's anything that you think is worrying you, you need to have even one person who you can discuss it with. Sometimes we like to bottle up a lot of things and put them inside our heart, inside our mind. That doesn't make us any stronger. What makes us strong is speaking out, talking about the issues that we face, so that we don't, you know, transfer the aggression of the pains that we are going through. We don't transfer it to our children, to our colleagues, to our, you know, to our family. Because what worries me a lot is, you know, how our children are, you know, being slaughtered on the streets. And then you think, what is happening? That means the family, there's serious family breakdown that needs to be addressed. And each and every one of us as women must think deeply, how are we going to contribute in stopping and taking care of this situation? We can't continue to, you know, blame the government, blame everybody, blame everything. We need to start looking at ourselves, even as it is now. What role are we playing to make sure we provide the comfortable and the, you know, good environment for our children to develop? How are you bringing up the child around you? What are you doing to make sure that your children pick up the right values? What are the priorities we are giving to our children? I see sometimes you see some families, some parents, they are so, you know, their priority is to get all the gadgets for their children. They don't even have time. You know, they don't have time to sit even for 1 minute and discuss issues with their kids. These kids, they start getting ideas from outside there. You know, that is why, like I said earlier, it's very, very important for us as women to make sure that our role in the family is valued and respected. You know, equality is not about earning the same amount of money that your husband is earning, fighting who is going to be the breadwinner. No, for me personally, in every situation, wherever you are, and making sure that that your role is being respected and valued. I don't know if I'm making sense.
Yes,
because these days, you see, men and women, everybody is struggling to, you know, have a job, struggling to be the breadwinner, struggling to be the one providing for the family, struggling to be the one who has more money, who is bringing more money to the family. Whenever you see that, the children are in trouble. That family is in trouble because when the priority is who is making the money, that means there's no respect, there's no value, and there's no respect, there's no value in that family, and that brings a lot of problem both for the individuals involved and for the community at large. So with that, I'm coming to the end of my talk. I hope that you guys got some values from what I've said. I will wrap up for me to press for progress. I will tell women, one, be careful in the relationship you get into. Make sure whoever you get involved with values, respects, and what's the next thing?
Appreciate.
Yes, appreciate your role in that relationship. Two, make sure that your mental health at all times is intact. And the third one, wherever you find yourself, make sure that your priorities are also intact. And then that's how you press for progress. Thank you.